Hello students, today let us see how the value of small g, that is gravitational acceleration, changes with respect to altitude or depth or going from equator to pole across the surface of the earth. So what will be the effect on the gravitational acceleration of the altitude? It means when any object attains some height from the earth's surface, then what will be the change in the magnitude of the gravitational acceleration? Let us see this by a simple calculation, that is change in acceleration or gravitational acceleration, or simply g, with altitude. So for this, if we assume that this is the surface of earth and here is an object of mass m and it is placed just at the surface of this earth, this is the center of the earth, and the radius of the earth is assumed as Re, that is radius of earth, and the total mass of the earth can be considered as Me, mass of earth. So when this mass object is placed at just at the surface, then the force experiencing by this mass object will be equal to Mg, and this force is also is equal to the universal gravitational force acting between two different mass object, that is equal to g me, that is mass of earth multiplied by mass of the object divided by the distance between the center of these object, that is from the center of the earth to the center of object. Because the size of the mass object is very small, so the distance between the center and the lower part of this mass is same, so the distance can be taken as Re, because the size of the object is smaller and negligible in comparison to the size of earth. So this is equal to this. So this is from the Newton's universal law of gravitation, and this is according to definition of the weight of any object at where the gravitational acceleration is present by the value g. So from here we are seeing that g is equal to what? G m e divided by r e square. This is equation number 1. From here m and m is cancelled both sides. So from here we get that g equal to g m e divided by r e square. Alright. Now suppose that this mass object is attain some height during going along the altitude. So after some time, if this mass object reached at this point, okay, so suppose that the height attained by the mass object from the earth surface is h, and if we assume that the value of the gravitational acceleration g at this point is g dash, so if we again apply this formula, then we get what? The force experiencing by this object due to this is the, simply we can say that the weight of this object at this point will be equal to mg dash, and this will be equal to the universal law of gravitation. It means the force of universal gravitation acting between these two different mass object. So from here we get g m e into m divided by the distance of the center between these mass object, that is r e plus h whole square. So from here we get that g dash is equal to g m e divided by r e plus h square. This is equation number 2. From here we are seeing that the value of g is larger as the denominator is small, but in this g dash will be smaller because the denominator becomes larger than this one. So the value of this becomes smaller. It means the value of g dash is smaller in comparison to g. So how much change in the g? So we want to calculate this change in g with altitude. So let us calculate it. Now this will be equal to g dash equal to gme divided by, if we take re as common from both term, then we found that this becomes re square, because there is a square, so re comes with the square term, and here becomes 1 plus here h by re whole square, because in this term re is not present, so we multiply and divide the re, and which term which is multiplied, that can be taken as outside, and divided term are remaining at here. So this becomes like this. So we can write it as what? You are seeing that this term is gme by re square. So gme by re square can be written as what? G. So this becomes g divided by 1 plus h by re whole square. So if we write it as, then we get g whole into 1 plus h by re whole square. Then if we take this term from denominator to numerator, then the power of this term becomes negative. Okay, if we explain this by binomial expansion, then we get g dash equal to g whole into 1 plus nx, that is minus 2 into h by re, plus n into n minus 1, minus 2 into minus 2 minus 1, divided by 2 into 1 whole into x square, that is h by re whole square, plus and so on. So we got that g dash equal to, if we multiply the g in each term, then we get g, and this is minus g twice of gh divided by re, and fill from here minus, and minus becomes plus, so this becomes plus, and this becomes cancelled to each other, so there is nothing. Here becomes h by re whole square, plus and so on. This term is also contained the term g. So if we put all these term in the right side, left side, and this one g dash is taken as in the left side, then we get what? G minus g dash. G minus g dash is equal to, this becomes positive, that is taken in the left side, so 2gh by re, and this one becomes negative 2g whole of h by re whole square, all other term. So we are finding out what will be the change in the gravitational acceleration, that will be given by a formula 2gh by re minus g whole into h by re whole square, plus and so on, different terms. So if we assume the altitude attained by an object is very small in comparison to the radius of the earth, it means if we assume that h is very small in comparison to re, then h square will be much smaller in comparison to re square. So h, if we divide the h by re, then this value will obtained as very small, and this will be negligible in comparison to this one term. So this higher and this second and higher order term can be negligible, as taken at here, so we get the change in the g with a finite or a small altitude is given by a formula 2gh by re. Okay, this is the small slight change in the gravitational acceleration with the altitude. Okay, and we can also find from here what will be the amount of gravitational acceleration at an altitude h. So at an altitude, if the value of g is d dash, then from here g dash can be written as what? G multiplied by here g minus 2 gh divided by re plus g into h by re whole square plus and so on. So if we take h is very small in comparison to re, second and higher order term will be taken as negligible. So from here we get g dash will be equal to g minus 2 gh by re. So from here we get g dash equal to g 1 minus 2s of h by re. So this is the formula for the new acceleration or new gravitational acceleration when any object reached at an altitude of h, which is very small in comparison to the radius of the earth. Similarly, we can also see what will be the value of the g when an object is going into a drift inside the earth center. So suppose that if we go inside a trench, then the value of g is also decreases continuously. We can see this by a simple calculation like this, and we can also obtain a formula. So let us study about change in g with depth. So suppose that this is the earth and this one is the center of earth, and an object is placed initially at the surface of earth whose mass is m. The mass of earth is me, radius of the earth is re. Then the weight of the object that can be given by mg can be expressed at the surface of earth will be equal to g me m whole divided by re square. So from here you will easily obtain that the value of g is g me divided by re square. This is equation number 1. Now if we talk about at any depth point, suppose that if we dig inside the earth, then we reached at any point p inside the earth, then if the mass object is placed at this point, then what will be the distance between these two mass object, that is sun, earth and the mass object. So if we form a spherical part of the earth in the symmetrical region, so this one can be considered as the mass object that affected the force of gravitation at this mass object. So what will be the mass of this region which applied a force of gravitation at any object placed at this point? So this will be equal to what? So suppose that this one is the total distance from the earth's region is if the length of the range of the depth is d, then this becomes re minus d. Okay, so this distance is treated as what? Re minus d. So as we know that the total density of the earth is taken as rho, suppose that the average density of the earth is considered as rho, then total mass of earth can be defined as the volume multiplied by its density. It means rho whole into 4 by 3 pi r e cube. But if you want to calculate what will be the mass of this region only, then this will be equal to rho multiplied by 4 by 3 pi r e minus d cube. So if we want to write the mass of this object or this region of earth in terms of m e, then we have to eliminate this rho from this term. So from here we get rho will be equal to m e divided by 4 pi by 3 r e cube. So if we replace this rho with the formula, then we get m e dash is equal to m e divided by 4 pi by 3 r e cube into 4 by 3 pi r e minus d cube. So from here 4 by 3 4 by 3 will cancel each other, and we get mass m e dash is equal to m e times the r e minus d cube divided by r e cube. This is the mass of the earth's region which affected or which provides the gravitational force to pulling the object towards a center to the mass object of mass m. So if we assume that the gravitational acceleration at this point is g dash, then the force of attraction that can be equal to mg dash, that can also be written as in the form of g m e dash m divided by r e minus d square. So if we put if you cancel this m in both term, then we get g dash equal to g m e dash divided by r e minus d square. So if we put the value of m e dash from here in this term, then we get g dash is equal to g into m e into r e minus d cube divided by r e cube, and from here r e minus d square. So this square will cancel by this cube, and 1 r e minus d is remaining at here. So from here we get g dash equal to g m e r e minus d divided by r e cube. Okay, so if we break this r e cube in two terms, r e square and r e, if we break this r e cube in two terms, that is r e square dot r e, so from here we can easily get that this is the value of g. You are seeing that the value of g is g m e by r e square. So from here you can place at here, then you get that g dash is equal to g whole into r e minus d divided by r e. So you got a formula from here, g dash is equal to what? R e by r e, that is 1 minus d by r e. So this becomes 1 minus d by r e. This is a simple formula for the new acceleration at any depth. Okay, so what will be the change in g with depth? So if we multiply this g in both term, then from here we get g dash equal to g minus dg by r e. From here we get what? G dash equal to g minus dg by r e. So if we place this in the left side and this one is the right side, then this minus becomes plus, that is dg by r e is equal to g minus g dash, that is dg by r e. So this is the change in acceleration with depth. This becomes dg by r e. Okay, this is the required formula. So we are seeing that there is a finite and positive change in the gravitational acceleration. It means when we are going into a depth, then the value of the gravitational acceleration decreases continuously. And suppose that if we reached at center of the earth, then what will be the value of g? This becomes zero, because if we put the value of d as re, so if we put the d as re at here, then re by re, that becomes 1, 1 minus 1, that is 0, so g multiplied by 0, so g dash, it means the new acceleration at the center of the earth becomes 0. Okay, so this is all about the variation of the g with the depth and change in the value of g with depth. So now seeing that when we are going at an altitude, then the value of gravitational acceleration decreases continuously, and also when we are going into a depth, then the value of g is all again decreases. Now if we want to calculate what will be the value of g when a person is going from the equatorial position to the polar region, so in this case we are also seeing that the magnitude of the g decreases. So we cannot derive an expression for that, but only explain it by a simple method, and because this is not in your syllabus, so only you want to know what is the main cause. So earth is not just in perfect spherical form, it is elliptical, and due to rotation about its axis, the heavier part which have a large radius, this increases, and the part which is near the axis of rotation, they shrinks. So the real shape of the earth due to its rotation about its axis becomes like some that. Okay, so we are seeing that the radius of earth at equator is higher in comparison to the radius of earth at pole. So when the distance, in the formula of g, we have found that g me divided by re, so this radius of earth is the average radius of earth. But when we are placed at the equatorial line, then the radius of earth is larger in comparison to when we are placed at the polar region. So radius of earth at polar is smaller in comparison to the equator. So when this is larger, then the value of g is small, and when this is decreases by a finite value, then value of g increases. So we can easily guess that the value of the gravitational acceleration at the equator is very small in comparison, very small change containing value in comparison to the magnitude of the gravitational acceleration at the pole. So the value of the gravitational acceleration pole, suppose that g at p minus g at equator, so this possesses a very small value in the gravitational acceleration. So this can be further explained in next 11th, when you study about the chapter gravitation, then I will provide a good explanation and also derivation for the change in the gravitational acceleration when any object is moving along the equator to the pole. It means the variation in g with latitude. Okay, till now take care, thank you.